Hello, good morning, student. I welcome you all to my class of English. And today, children, we are going to do the second part of the lesson, The Sound of Music, which is chapter number 2 of your book, Beehive, which is, and the writer is Deborah Colley. So, first part, children, we have completed. What was the first part? Evelyn Glennie, she used to hear, she learns the music without hearing. And the second part is The Shehnai of Bismillah Khan. As you all know, Bismillah Khan, he was from our own town, Varanasi. Now, and children, this lesson presents the biography of India's illustrious son, Bismillah Khan. A man who has risen from the rank of an ordinary class, the author traced the humble origin of the legendary Shehnai maestro, who neither boasted of any royal background nor any great educated or powerful family. So he was a very simple-hearted person. He was one of the best Shehnai player of India, awarded with a lot of Padam Shri and all that thing, which I will be reading to you. And he never boasted that he is from a very good family. Just by the sheer dint of his hard work, he rose to become an awardee of the Bharat Ratna, the greatest civilian honor of India. Just because of hard work, children, he rose to become an awardee of the Bharat Ratna, which is one of the greatest civilian honor of India. As an artist, he is unique. And so is his love for motherland India. Not only as an artist, he is unique. He is a very patriotic person. I will tell you what he replied to his student who wanted to come and settle him in America. So he had got a love for his motherland India. He had the privilege of playing the Shehnai on the occasion of first Independence Day of India, that is 15 August 1947. So he was the first person to play Shehnai when our country got independent on 15 August 1947. He is still as in love with Benaras and Dumrao. Children, his life, his heart, his soul lies in Varanasi and Dumrao. As when he was a small baby, he passed his days here. He can't tolerate his separation from these places. The lesson is a great journey in the life of an ordinary looking man with extraordinary achievements. Ordinary man with extraordinary achievements. Okay, so this part 2. Children, the lesson is start with Emperor Aurangzeb, who banned the playing of Pungai. Pungai is a, children, it's a musical instrument which has a shrill and unpleasant noise. It was revived by a barber in his court with some improvisation and got a name, Shehnai. How it got a name, that I will be telling you when we will start the lesson. The sound of Shehnai was considered auspicious, and it is a part of North Indian wedding, children. It is one of the most auspicious occasion, like in wedding ceremonies, or if some mundan ceremony is there, or children, if the inauguration of some school or building is there, then the Shehnai is played in North India. Earlier, Khan Saab was a player of Gilli Danda, but later on he earned Bharat Ratna. So still when he was small, he used to play Gilli Danda. But now when he grew up, he was a maestro of Shehnai and he earned Bharat Ratna from there. Everyone from Khansa family was a professional musician, but he never boasted about it. Bismillah Khan used to practice music on the bank of River Ganga for hours, and he became perfect in the art. He had his program in the All India Radio and impressed all his listeners. He received many awards and recognition from all over the world. He received highest civilian awards of India, the Bharat Ratna, in 2001. He refused a prestigious offer, a job in USA, for opening a musical center there. He was a true patriot and a legendary musician of India. So now I will be telling you something more about Bismillah Khan. So children, I think I've already told you enough. And children, he died also in Varanasi, and he loved his city very much. So children, I will be reading you something about Bismillah Khan, and about I will be telling you what is there in this lesson. Emperor Aurangzeb banned the playing of pungai in the palace. Pungai is a musical instrument with a shrill noise. The reason was that it had a sharp and unpleasant noise. So why he banned? Because it had a sharp and unpleasant sound. A barber thought to improve it. He chose a pipe with a natural hollow stem. So children, a barber thought he would improve that pungai and with a natural hollow stem. He made 7 holes on its body. So children, 7 holes was made on its body. He played on it, closing and opening some of these holes. It produced a sweet sound. He played it before the royalty. It needed a name. So it was named the Shehnai, after the player who was a Nai. Nai is a Hindi word for Baba. So since he made that new instrument, so he was named Shehnai, Shah Barber. And it was played in the Shah's chamber. So it was played in the Shah's chamber. So the first name was Shah. And Nai, it was made by Nai. He improved. So it was, Shehnai was named after his name, that is Shehnai. The sound of Shehnai was considered auspicious. So it is played in temples and at wedding places in North India, as I told you. Earlier, it was a part of the traditional music group. Ustad Bismillah Khan has brought it onto the classical stage. As a 5-year-old, Bismillah Khan played Gulli Danda near a pond in Dumrao in Bihar. He would go to the nearby Biharji's temple to sing the Bhojpuri Chaitya. At the end, he would children earn a big laddu. And just because that, he used to go to the temple, though he was a Muslim fellow, but he used to sing Chaitya. It's a type of song. At the end, he would earn a big laddu weighing 1.25 kg. It was on the behalf of the local Maharaja. This happened 80 years ago. This little boy later earned the Bharat Rant. It is the highest civilian honor. Bismillah Khan was born on March 21, 1916, in a family of musicians in Bihar. His grandfather, Rasool Bakhsh Khan, was the Shehnai Nawaz of the Bhojpur King's Court. So you can see, children, he came, almost children, his father was connected to the royal family. He used to work in Bhojpur King's Court. His father, Peghambar Bakhsh, and other ancestors were great Shehnai player. The young boy Bismillah took to music early in life. At 3, his mother took him to his maternal uncle's house in Benares. He was attracted toward his uncle practice the Shehnai. Soon he started going with his uncle Ali Bakhsh to the Vishnu temple in Varanasi to play the Shehnai. Soon he started practicing the playing of the instrument there. For years, the temple of Balaji and Mangla Maya and the banks of the Ganga became the places where he could practice. The flowing water of the Ganga inspired him to invent ragas. At the age of 14, Bismillah accompanied his uncle to the Allahabad Music Conference. The opening of the All India Radio in Lucknow in 1938 became a big break for him. He became a Shehnai player on radio. Bismillah Khan became the first Indian to greet the nation with his Shehnai on August 15, 1947. He played Raag Kaifi from Red Fort to people like Mahatma Gandhi and Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. Bismillah Khan has given many memorable performances both in India and abroad. His first trip abroad was to Afghanistan. King Zahir Shah was deeply impressed by his shehnai. He gave him priceless Persian carpet. Film director Vijay Bhatt was so impressed that he named his film Children Gooj Uthi Shehnai after the instrument. The film was a hit and his composition Dil Ka Khilona Toot Gaya became a record breaker. Bismillah Khan music in films did not go beyond Vijay Bhatt Gooj Uthi Shehnai and Vikram Srinivas's Kannada film Sanadhi Appanna. He did not come to terms with the artificiality and glamour of the film world. So he boycotted Bollywood. He knew that this artificial and glamorous world is not for him. Awards came to plenty of awards were won by him. He became the first Indian to perform at the Lincoln Center Hall in the United States of America. He took part in the World Exposition in Montreal, in the Cannes Art Festival, and in the Osaka Trade Fair. An auditorium in Tehran was named after him, Tahir Mosque Ustad Bismillah Khan. National awards like the Padma Shri, the Padma Bhushan, and the Padma Vibhushan were conferred on him. In 2001, he was awarded India's highest civilian award, the Bharat Ratna. At this, he said, "Teach your children music. This is Hindustan's richest tradition." So children, he loved Indian classical music and he did not go for pop music or any other Western music. He told the Indians, he told his countrymen that tell your children to learn India's classical music. Even the West is now coming to learn our music. Bismillah Khan has traveled all over the world, but he is greatly fond of Benaras and Dumrah. A student of his once wanted him to head a Shehnai school in the United States of America. He promised to recreate an atmosphere of Benaras by making temples there. But Khan Saab asked him if he would transport River Ganga there. He told, "Okay, I will come. But what about River Ganga? Can you transport it to USA?" So that his student, he kept quiet. He says that whenever he is abroad, he earns to see Hindustan. While in Mumbai, he thinks of only Varanasi. Even sometimes when he goes to Varanasi, he thinks of only Varanasi and of course, Holy Ganga. And while in Varanasi, he misses the mutt in Dumrao. So children, though he was a Muslim, but see how faithful and loyal and how auspicious was Ganga to him. And he even was so patriotic that he told his student that he will not go to USA because there he will not find Ganga. Ustad Bismillah Khan's life is a perfect example of the rich cultural heritage of India. It accepts that a Muslim like him can play the Shehnai every morning at the Kashi Vishwanath temple. So you won't surprise children, he used to play his Shehnai at Kashi Vishwanath temple, a very famous temple of Varanasi. So now I will be children telling you some summary, point-wise summary. So my first point is origin of Shehnai. So Bismillah Khan is a legendary figure of India. He is the undisputed monarch of Shehnai. He belongs to a family of professional musician. A story goes on about Shehnai that there was a barber who had an access to the royal palace. He was also from the family of a professional musician. Initially, Pungi was played in the royal palaces or residence. It has a shrill and unpleasant sound. So the emperor Aurangzeb banned the playing of pungai. The barber decided to bring some improvement in its tonal quality. He took a long hollow pipe. He made 7 holes on it. When he played on it, sweet and soft sounds were produced. All were influenced. As the story goes, a new name was given to it since it was played in the Shah's chamber and played by a Nai. So it was named Shehnai. So once again I will tell, as the story goes, a new name was given to him since it was placed in the Shah's chamber and played by a Nai. So it was named Shehnai. Since it was played in the Shah chamber and played by a Nai, so it was named Shehnai. Its sound is considered very holy or auspicious. So it is played on auspicious occasion like marriage, mundan ceremony, some inaugural ceremony. Ustad Bismillah Khan brought it on to the classical stage. So children, that Shehnai was brought to the stage by Ustad Bismillah Khan. Now I'm going to tell you something now about Ustad Bismillah Khan once again. Okay, Bismillah Khan was born on March 21, 1916 in Bihar. His grandfather Rasool Bakhsh Khan was the Shehnai Nawaz of the Bhojpur King's court. His father Peghambar Bakhsh was also a great Shehnai player. As a 5-year child, he played Gilli Danda to Dumra. At the Biharis temple, he would sing Chaitya and earn rupees, and earn, not sorry, rupees, 1.25 kgs of a big laddu from the local Maharaja. And children, why? Because he used to sing Chaitya. And when he was 3 years old, his mother took him to his maternal uncle in Banaras. There he was fascinated seeing his uncle practice in Shehnai. Ali Bakhsh played on Shehnai at the Vishnu temple. Bismillah sat beside him for hours together, watch him very carefully. Ali Bakhsh played on Shehnai at the Vishnu temple. Bismillah sat beside him for hours together. Slowly, he started getting lessons in it and practice the whole day. The temple of Balaji and Mangla Maya and the banks of the Ganga became his favorite haunt. The flowing waters at the Ganges or the Ganga inspired him. There he invented ragas. In 1938, All India Radio station was opened in Lucknow. Bismillah Khan showed his art. He was the first one to play his Shehnai there. Thus, he became a Shehnai player on the radio. Now, children, the next point is memorable performance. On 15th August 1947, when India got independence, Bismillah Khan was the first Indian. He greeted the nation with Shehnai from the Red Fort. Then he visited Afghanistan. King Zahir Shah was charmed by his music and offered him many rewards. Like children, he presented him Persian carpet also. Even the film director Vijay Bhatt was also impressed by Khan's Shehnai. He named a film Gooj Uthi Shehnai. Bismillah Khan worked in Dil Ka Khilona Hai Toot Gaya and Sanadhi's Appana South Indians film, but he did not like the glamorous and artificial world of Bollywood. He planned that he would not work there. He was invited at Lincoln Center Hall in the USA. He took part in the World Exposition in Montreal, in the Cannes Art Festival, and in the Osaka Trade Fair. The country of Tehran named an auditorium as Tahir Mosque, Mosque Ustad Bismillah Khan. National awards like the Padma Shri, the Padma Bhushan, just see, he got so many national awards, the Padma Shri, the Padma Bhushan and the Padma Vibhushan, all the three, Padma Shri, Padma Bhushan and Padma Vibhushan, were awarded to him. In 2001, Bismillah Khan was awarded the highest Indian civil award, the Bharat Ratna. After getting the award, he said, "All I would like to say is teach your children music. This is Hindustan's richest tradition. Even the West is now coming to learn our music." So children, he had got so much love for India, Ganges, Varanasi, Dumrau, the culture of India, the classical music of India. So children, Bismillah Khan, he loved our country, he loved India very much. In spite of his wide travel, he is fond of Banaras and Dumrau. Once a student urged him in the United States of America to head a Shehnai school, but Khan Sahab asked him if he could transport Ganga there. Bismillah Khan says, when he is in a foreign country, he goes on earning to see Hindustan. And when he is in Mumbai, he thinks of Varanasi and the holy Ganga. In Varanasi, he longs for unique mud in Dumrau. Being a devotee Muslim, he is a perfect example of the rich cultural heritage of India. So children, this was the story of Bismillah Khan. And now children, I will be reading you the book. I've explained you about the author. I've explained you about the children, the background. Okay, and now we will be doing the reading and the explanation of the new word. So now I'm going to read the lesson, children. Please hear carefully, and you have to write the new words also. So, Emperor Aurangzeb banned the playing of a musical instrument called Pungai in the royal residence, for it had a shrill, unpleasant sound. Okay, so what is the meaning of banned? Banned means prohibited. Called Pungai in the royal residence, for it had a shrill, unpleasant sound. Pungai became the generic name for reeded noisemaker. So children, shrill is sharp. Okay, shrill is and now children, the next word is residential building, generic name, that is a name given to a class or group as a goal. So generic name is a name given to a class or group as a whole. So this is the meaning of generic. Generic name for reeded noisemaker. Reeded is a wind instrument which have reeds like flute. Read it, you can note it down. Wind instrument which have reeds like flute. Few had thought that it would one day be revived. Revived means regain. So only few people have thought that would be regained. That Pungai would be regained. Barber means hairdresser, the person who cuts your hair. A barber of a family of professional musicians. So children, a barber whose family was a professional musician, though he was cutting the hair, would access to the royal palace. So children, he went to the royal palace. Decided to improve the tonal quality of the Pungai. And what he decided, that he would improve the tonal quality of Pungai. Okay. Now, he chose a pipe with a natural hollow stem. Hollow is vacant. What is the meaning of hollow? Vacant. He chose a pipe with a natural hollow stem that was longer and broader than the pungai, and he made 7 holes on the body of the pipe. When he played on it, closing and opening of some of these holes, soft and melodious sounds were heard. So children, after making 7 holes in that reed, when he opened, sometime he was opening, sometime he was closing that hole, and children, what he found, that is soft, and it was not a shrill now a noise was coming, a soft and a melodious noise was coming from the instrument. Children, you can see in your book the pungai and shehnai. You can see the difference between pungai and shehnai. He played the instrument before royalty and everyone was impressed. Now children, he asked permission to the king, and he gave the permission. He played the instrument before royalty and everybody was impressed. Everybody was impressed by the beautiful sound of the pungai. The instrument so different from the pungai had to be given a new name. Now children, that instrument was just opposite to pungai. Pungai had a shrill and unpleasant noise, but it had a soft and melodious noise. So they thought to give him a new name. As the stories goes on, so children, as the stories goes on, since it was first played in the Shah's chamber and was played by a Nai, Nai means barber, the instrument was named the Shehnai. So children, since it was played for the first time in the Shah chamber and was played by a Nai, the instrument was named Shehnai. The sound of the, now children, I am here at page number 22, the second paragraph. So children, in this way, that Nai, that barber, he has turned that shrill voice of pungai to a beautiful melodious sound of shehnai. And when the royalty heard that, the member of the royal family heard, they accepted it and they were happy. And it was given, since this, it was first played in the Shah chamber and was played by a Nai, so the instrument was named Shehnai. Shah means king, Nai means barber. Well, now we are here at the second paragraph. The sound of the shehnai began to be considered auspicious. Now children, that auspicious is holy, proving to bring good fortune. What is the meaning of auspicious? Holy and to bring good good. So children, that shehnai, it was considered to be, children, it was considered auspicious. So children, the sound of the shehnai began to be considered auspicious. Auspicious, I have written holy and to bring good fortune. Okay, so that for this reason, it is still played in the temples and in an indispensable component of any North Indian wedding. Indispensable means without a which a piece of work can't be done. That means children, without that thing, tradition seem to be incomplete. And for this reason, it is still played in the temple and it is an indispensable component of a North Indian wedding. In the past, the shehnai was part of the nobat, or traditional ensemble of 9 instruments found at royal court. So children, earlier children, it was a part of a nobat. What is a nobat? children, the shanai was a part of the nobat, okay, and or traditional ensemble of 9 instrument found at royal court. Nobat was a 9 types of instrument, and among them shanai was also found at royal court. Till recently it was only in temples and weddings. Then finally, children, it was only played in the temples and in the wedding ceremony, because it is considered as one of the most auspicious thing. The credit for bringing this instrument onto the classical stage goes to Ustad Bismillah Khan. Now here, children, there is a turning point. Now after this, I told you that how shehnai originated, and now we will be turning to the Bismillah Khan. My this video related with Bismillah Khan will be my next video. And now, since this is the end of time, that I conclude my video here. Thank you and have a nice day ahead.